Welcome back to the shed. It's that time of year again. Happy Easter, everybody. Let's make a skeleton on the bandsaw. Did someone say bandsaw? Well, what a coincidence, because that's where we're going to turn this 6x2 into limb blanks. We need 4 arm pieces, 4 leg pieces, 1 torso piece, and a piece for the skull. Look at that, it's a robot. Hold on, we're making a skeleton. These templates are going to turn our robot into a skeleton. That's the bare bones explanation. Let's get them stuck together. I recommend using a glue stick to attach your templates, but I can't find mine, so this messy spray adhesive will have to do instead. Arm 1 template is attached and ready for the bandsaw. The lines on the template are nice and wide and make cutting to the line a little easier, in theory. Anyway, that's template A cut. Let's stick it all back together and cut the B side. All the cool kids prefer the B side. Look at that, it's an arm shape. Arm 2 template is attached and ready for the bandsaw. Cut to the template line. Stick it back together. And cut to the template line. Seeing a 3D shape emerge from this block of wood never fails to put a smile on my face. Leg 1 template is attached and ready for the bandsaw. You don't have to be Sherlock Bones to figure out what's happening now. It's a leg 1. Leg 2 template is attached and... You guessed it. It's a leg 2. The skull template is attached and you'll be surprised to hear. We're going to cut it out on the bandsaw. Same method as the arms and the legs. Cut it, stick it back together, and cut it again. The middle bit template is attached and... cut out on the bandsaw. Nope, it's too big. Now we can cut it out on the bandsaw. It's still a bit big and that's why I'm struggling a bit. There we go. Let's stick it back together and cut the other side. I've only shown cutting half of the skeleton because I'm quite conscious that I might be repeating myself. Look at that, it's a skeleton. This is where we say goodbye to the bandsaw and hello to the spokeshave. Hello, spokeshave! Not all spokeshaves are created equal. This one, for instance, is smaller and it fits in tight spaces. Look how cute it is. Whether your spoke shave is cute or not, we can all agree that they've done an amazing job at shaping these arm ones. Arm 2 is in the vise for some spoke shave treatment. A close-up view shows just how effective this tool is. With a skewed cut, it tackles end grain beautifully. Hand tools are so much fun. If Veritas want to send me some free tools, I promise I'll use them in every video. Let's shake on it. The skull is in the vise now, but don't worry, I'm not Nicky Santoro and this skull doesn't belong to McCarthy. If you got that reference, please type casino in the comments. I've glued the two halves of the middle bit together so we can have one middle bit. Truth be told, I didn't do a brilliant job of cutting them out. And as you can see, there is a lot of shaping to do. The spoke shave can fix some of it, but this bit of the middle bit is going to require another tool. Ashley Isles was a pattern maker who started his firm in 1949. That's where all these come from. Ashley's eldest son Raymond continued the family tradition of tool making, but uses his own name. That's where this draw knife came from. British made tools being used by a British person in a British built shed. Hopefully that'll make Veritas jealous enough to send me some free stuff. Look at that, it's a slightly less robotic middle bit. We've had lots of fun so far, but this is a Halloween video. We should probably do something spooky. There's one word that strikes fear into the hearts of most woodworkers. A word so powerful that even the mention of it can cause flashbacks and, in some cases, physical pain. That word is sanding. There's nothing scary about sanding. Strap yourself in. It's time to assemble the skeleton.
No, not again. Anything but that. He's terrible at painting. He's alive. He's alive. I made you, so I'll destroy you. I'll turn back time, so you were never born.
Well, look at that, it's a skeleton. I'll tell you what, let's make a robot instead.